गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम। डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी आर इन दिस भाष्यम अंडर द सेकंड श्लोक ऑफ 13th चैप्टर ऑफ गीता। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर जस्ट डिस्कसिंग द डिबेट बिटवीन द सिद्धांति एंड द पूर्वपक्षी। दट ईज द थ्री पॉइंट्स विच वर अंडर डिस्कशन। दट ईज नंबर वन इज हाउ कैन क्षेत्रज्ञ बी ईश्वर। How can there be equation between Jiva and Ishvara? So that was one question. Then if you say so, then it will lead to Shastra Anarthakyam. That is the futility of the Shastras. All these scriptures which are talking about Dharma, Adharma, good, bad, etc., etc., which are giving you some prescriptions and then some injunctions, not to do some prohibitions, etc., etc., all these things will become irrelevant. Then the other question which of course we are going to see is avidya, that is ignorance. Where exactly is it located? What is the locus of this avidya? That also of course we will see. So in the last class, the last paragraph we read was that this Dvaitin, this dualist does not mean the present day Dvaitin. Even prior to Shankaracharya, right from the Upanishadic days, there are two broad ways of thinking. One is the non-dualist approach and the other is the dualist approach. Dualist approach is right from the days of this Gautama Nyaya Sutra, Karnadas Vaisheshika Darshana. Right from that time, all this dualist thinking also is there. Shankaracharya's time, there was no Madhvacharya. Madhvacharya came about 7-8 centuries later. 4-5 centuries later. But we are now referring to Dvaita. Dvaita means subsequently, of course, all these arguments have been taken up by Madhvacharya and some other dualists. But then Shankaracharya is referring to the then logicians who were dualists. So these dualists are not able to accept the position that Jiva is equal to Ishvara. They are very comfortable with this dualist mode of worship. So that is why the Purvapakshi was saying, for us, there is what is called a Bandhavastha and Muktavastha. So because there is a Bandhavastha and Muktavastha, the Shastras will become relevant, because the Shastra will tell us as to what to do and then we to get liberated. So that is what it is. But in your case, you are all wise people, you claim to be very, very wise people. In your case, you don't accept this Bandhavastha and Muktavastha in real terms. So the Shastra is irrelevant for you. Then how can you hold that position? So because Shastra Anarthakyam is not agreeable to anybody, isn't it? Whether he is a non-dualist or a dualist. If for a non-dualist, Shastra Anarthakyam is acceptable at a very, very exceptional stage. That is, after you become a jnani. After you become a jnani, for you only, that Shastra may not be relevant. But still you will be following. You will be doing Sandhyavandana, you will be doing Devatarchana as long as you are a Gruhastha. As long as you are a Gruhastha, you will also be doing some Gruhastha karma. But that is a karma abhasa. So we are not talking about that level. For all practical purposes, even a non-dualist will not say that he will not agree for a situation where there is irrelevance of Shastras. So he says, so you are all wise people. So you, for you, this Shastra will be anarthakam, meaningless. So for that again, the Siddhanti. Siddhanti means Shankaracharya or non-dualist, let us say. The non-dualist is saying, there cannot be avastha bheda. There cannot be two avasthas in Atma. Atma is something which is of the nature of consciousness, which is a pure entity. There is no question of avastha. That is, avastha means a vikara. Avastha means a stage. For example, a jagrat avastha, then nidra avastha, swapna avastha, nidra avastha, etc., etc. Similarly, balyavastha. Yavana balyavastha means childhood. Then again you become adolescent, then again you become a youth, then you become an old man, and then you pop off. So all these are stages, isn't it? So this is all vikara. Vikara means a change. Whatever changes is something which is non-eternal, whereas Atma is something which is eternal. So in Atma, you can't think of any avastha bheda. So that is what he said. And he also explained, so you have to explain, if at all you think of these two avasthas, you have to say which one is prior, bandhavastha is prior or mokshavastha is prior. Then again, how exactly, and they can't be there simultaneously in a person, because sthiti gati eva, bandhavastha and muktavastha cannot be there in one person at the same time. Then again, kramabhavitvecha, if they are sequential, nirnimitte, nirnimittatve anirmoksha prasangaha, nirnimitta, if it is without any cause, nirnimitta explained in the last class, nirnimitta, suppose I see one, say, snake in broad daylight with perfect vision. So it is a clear vision without any interference, nirnimitta, there is no interfering factor. So that is something which is real. So nirnimitte, if that bondage is so real, then there cannot be any moksha at all. And sanimittatve, if it is due to some nimitta, if it is due to some cause, like the semi-dark condition, I do observe a snake, I do observe some rope, and then I do see a rope, and then but see it as a snake, or maybe some defect in the eye. So if that is the case, that is sanimittatva, and my observation is something wrong. So that is why sanimittatve cha svataha abhavat. So that bandha itself is abhava, bandha itself is non-existing. So aparamarthatva prasangaha, what you say that this for us, this bandhavastha and mokshavastha are real. So that becomes negated. And if that is so, your own position will get negated. So you are accepting that bandham is paramartha, bandham is also real. So that position you are actually hitting at your own position. So that is where we stopped in the last class. Tatha cha sati abhyupagama hanihi. Abhyupagama hani means what you are actually hitting at your own accepted position. So that is the abhyupagama hani. Abhyupagama means accepting something. That is, this is our contention. So that is our abhyupagama. Abhyupagama hani means we hit at our own content, whatever we have accepted, we damage our own say standpoint. So that is it. So from there we have to read. Then again, Shankaracharya is again giving another he is continuing the argument. If this bandhavastha and muktavastha have to be accepted, then we have to see which is first and which is later. Which one can be the first and which one can be the later? Suppose you say mokshavastha is first and then bandhavastha is later. That is, a man, he is a highly liberated man, he gets into a bandhavastha. So if that is the position, what are the consequences? Then from moksha he has come to bandha means that moksha is something not eternal. Suppose you are in some heaven, dancing with some Ramba or somebody, and then suddenly you are snatched out and then pulled out and then thrown down on earth. So which means Swarga is not permanent, and that we know. Swarga is not permanent, we know. So that is why we don't bother much for Swarga. But then we say that moksha is something different. In moksha, of course, there is no dancing, there is no wine, there is nothing there. But then mokshavastha is a state of happiness. It is a state of bliss. Satyam, sattu chidu ananda. So that is that ananda, that bliss. And that bliss of somebody who has given up all desires. Shrotriyasya cha akamahatasya. We are going to see in Taittiriya Upanishad. Shrotriyasya cha akamahatasya. Have you heard about this line? Akamahataha. One who is not hit by any desire. One who is not afflicted by any desire. So this man, he has got the highest bliss. So that is the type of bliss we are aiming at, and not the bliss of dancing somewhere in heaven. So from heaven you are thrown out. So likewise, suppose then from moksha, you say that moksha is first and bandhavastha is later. From mokshavastha, if you are falling into bandhavastha, what does it mean? Moksha is not permanent. Moksha is not ananta. Moksha is not eternal. And nobody will bother for such a moksha, isn't it? If mokshavastha is something which is not at all eternal, it is as stupid as you are going to a pub and then having some drink or something like that. If that is so, then who will bother for that? Nobody will bother for this thing. So we have to jolly well say that bandhavastha is first and then thereafter comes moksha, isn't it? bandhavastha is first, and then we have to admit mokshavastha. So that Shankaracharya is discussing. If we say that bandhavastha and all that, then you are saying that bandhavastha and mokshavastha are real, isn't it? So if you say that bandhavastha and mokshavastha, that state of bondage and state of liberation, are real, then what are the consequences? So that is what we are going to see in this paragraph. Kincha bandhamuktavasthayoho paurvaparya nirupanayam paurvaparya
nirupanayam
bandhavastha purvam prakalpya anadimati anantavati cha.
Anadimati
anantavati cha. We have to break it as anadimati antavati cha. Tachya pramana viruddham. Tatha mokshavastha.
Tatha mokshavastha.
Adimatyanantacha.
Adimatyanantacha anantacha.
Pramana viruddhaiva abhyupagamyate.
Pramana viruddhaiva abhyupagamyate.
Mokshavastha adimatyananta means adimati ananta. Now because avastha is a strilinga, we have to say use it as anadimati antavati, so something like that. So here, Shankaracharya is examining. Suppose you say that bandhavastha is real and mokshavastha is also real. So paurvaparya nirupana, paurvaparya means which is purvam and which is aparam. Purvam means former, aparam means later. Paurvaparya nirupana means to decide as to which is former and which is later. Which is anterior, posterior, we need not use big words. Which is former and which is later. Paurvaparya nirupanayam. Then, as we discussed just now, we have to accept that bandhavastha is first, isn't it? You can't say that mokshavastha is first. You have to accept that bandhavastha is first. And then, bandhavastha purvam prakalpya. Prakalpya means you have to visualize. Prakalpya, kalpana. Kalpana means visualization. So, prakalpya means you have to accept it. Here, you have to accept it that way. You have to take it that way. And then, what is that bandhavastha? Anadimati antavatisha. So, then a question comes. For anything, say in Vedanta, we do discuss what is the adi and what is anta, isn't it? So, we are talking about bandhavastha. Then, when did this begin? Bandhavastha, when did this begin? This ignorance, etc., it's going on and on and on, isn't it? So, you have to say that it is anadi, isn't it? It has not started somewhere in the beginning. Because prior to that, there was no moksha, isn't it? If moksha were to be there and then from moksha you have come to bandhavastha, then, that point of time you can break. So, prior to that, there was no moksha. So, which means it goes back and back and back, isn't it? Prior to that, there is no mokshavastha. So, this bandhavastha goes back and back and back. So, anadi, it is anadi. Then, you are also accepting that this bandhavastha will come to an end, isn't it? You are going to worship some Lord Vishnu, Lord Shiva, etc., Venkateshwara, and then you are going to get moksha, you say. So, when that is so, then it is coming to an end. This bandhavastha is coming to an end. You are attaining moksha. So, that means, in other words, bandhavastha is anadimati antavati. Anadimati means that which is anadi, anadimat. Anadimat is napumsakalinga, anadiman pumlinga, anadimati is strilinga, isn't it? Anadimati antavati. It is anadi and anta, ending. And then, tachya pramana viruddham. That is against all pramanas. That is against all pramana, because anything which is beginningless has to be endless. That is the basic principle. In Tarka Shastra, there is a big discussion on that. So, the proof is, what is proved is, whatever is anadi is anantam. And whatever is sadi is santam. Sadi means that which has a beginning. Sadi and anadi, these two words you may note. Anadi means that which has no beginning. Sadi means that which has a beginning. Anything which is anadi has to be ananta. Anything which is sadi has to be santa. Santa means that which has an end. So here, this is pramana viruddham. To say that this avidya is this what is this bandhavastha, that is this state of bondage, is something which is beginningless but it is ending, it is contradicting the rules, contradicting the general pramanas. But then here we have to note a very, very subtle thing. It is of course not mentioned here. One commentator has mentioned it here. One commentator means sub-commentator, that is Bellamkonda Ramarai Kavi. You see, if you have read basic texts of Vedanta, avidya or ajnana, ajnanam, is it anadi or anadi, what is it? Adimati. Avidya is said to be, avidya or ajnanam, whatever it is said to be anadi. But at the same time, santam. It is coming to an end, isn't it? You can note down here, this is slightly different from avidya. So the situation here is, because you know shorthand, you can just note down. The point discussed here is something different from avidya or ajnana. Here, the dualist is talking about bandhavastha and muktavastha in real terms. Bandhavastha and muktavastha as real things. In the case of non-dualist, this avidya is something which is unreal. You are going to a totally different level. Avidya is something sad asadbhyam anirvachaniyam. That is something which you cannot say it exists, you can't say it does not exist. Sad asadbhyam anirvachaniyam. Regarding avidya in Vedanta say text, if you see, whether it is Vedanta Paribhasha or Vedanta Sara, then there will be some discussion on this, what exactly is avidya. So there the definition is avidya is something which is anadi. Sadasadbhyam anirvachaniyam. Then at the same time it is coming to an end. That is, once you have this realization of Brahma, then avidya goes, which means avidya is anadimati and antavati. So there that cannot be applied here. That is pramana viruddham, you can't say. Where that is, you are talking about unreal things. In the case of non-dualists, what do we say? That is, bandha is again fictitious, moksha is again fictitious, guru is fictitious. Yes, guru is fictitious, shastram is also fictitious, and your awareness, of course it is not fictitious. Awareness is this something like, there is a good example given. What is it? Suppose you are sleeping, you are dreaming rather. In a dream, suddenly you see some lion which is pouncing on you, some tiger pouncing on you, and you just wake up in fear. There is no lion, there is nothing, there is no tiger. And then you are perfectly okay. So this jnanam is something like that. And this whatever tiger or lion which you saw in your dream is something like your shastra. The shastra which has told you as to what exactly is Shastra has woken you up to reality, isn't it? So that is how, if you see, say, books like Naishkarmya Siddhi, etc., they where those things are described. This metaphor, where exactly it is from, I am not able to recall, but this metaphor is used by the Vedanta teachers. You are in a dream. And suddenly you wake up and then that dream is gone. The dream which is unreal, the dream is gone. And then you have come to reality. So similarly, the Shastra and Guru, all these things, though they are fictitious, though they are unreal, they are all in the avidya stage. They are all waking you up into a different level of reality. So that is why avidya is adimati and anadimati and antavati. So that cannot be compared here. So that is a totally different level, because we are talking about unreal thing there. In our case, in Vedanta, we say that this bandhavastha and muktavastha are totally unreal. Actually, atma is never bound, na baddhaha na muktaha. There is a beautiful shloka from Gaudapada Karika, that I am not able to recall. So there is actually no bandha, there is no moksha. Atma is always free, Atma is always liberated, Atma is always kevala. So it is all this the imagination is something like totally unreal. So that avidya should not be compared here. So otherwise, as a student of Vedanta, you may get a doubt because we are saying tachya pramana viruddham. Something which is anadi has to be ananta only. When we are talking about real things, when we are talking about bhava padartha, when we are talking about some real, say at the real level, at the Vedanta level or at the non-dual level, we are not talking that bandhavastha is real. So there, that principle holds. Are you clear about this? Because it is a slight, subtle point which you have to understand. Then, tatha mokshavastha adimati anantacha. Coming to mokshavastha now. Mokshavastha, what is it? It is adimati. Because you have been a bound, you have been a person who were in bondage for quite some time. And then from bondage, you are now liberated. So there is a point of time. So in 2014, so and so date, suddenly some flash, as Kena Upanishad says, suddenly some flash, after this Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, without Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, no flash will come. So after this Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, you have a flash, and then you say, okay, from here you are liberated. So when that is so, then your mokshavastha is adimati. And anantacha, adimati is again ananta. So how can this adimati be ananta? That again is pramana viruddham. Whatever has a beginning has an end. So that again, when you are talking in real terms, when you are talking in the plane of reality, whatever is adimati has to have an end. When we are talking about non-dual thing, it is a totally different case. When you are talking about Advaita level, where Bandhavastha is unreal, Mokshavastha is unreal, there, Adimati, Antavati, etc. may hold good. But then here, Adimati, Anantacha, Pramana Viruddham. This again is Pramana Viruddha. Pramana Viruddha eva Abhyupagamyate. So by you are accepting these two things which are against pramana. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Then nacha avasthavataha.
Nacha avasthavataha.
Avasthantaram gachataha. Nityatvam upapadayitum shakyam. Okay. Suppose you say Shankaracharya is anticipating some argument from the contender. Suppose the contender says, avasthavataha avasthantaram gachataha. Suppose one thing, a thing which is having a transition from one stage to another. From bandhavastha there is a muktavastha. From one avastha, avasthantaram gachataha. It is going to some other avastha. For that, okay, it is nitya. Suppose you want to say. You can't say that also. Because something which is changing, having so many avasthas, like Balyavastha, Kumaravastha, etc., you can't say it is nityam. Anything that is changing is anitya. So you can't say that something which is changing from one avastha to another, and then which is shedding some properties and which is acquiring some other properties, it will become nityam. So all that is unreal. So it is not shedding any properties, it is not acquiring any new properties. So that is it. Then atha, anityatva dosha pariharaya,
अनित्यत्व दोष परिहाराय
बंधमुक्तावस्था भेदो न कल्प्यते अतः द्वैतिनामपि शास्त्रानर्थक्य दोषः अपरिहार्य एव इति समानत्वात् न द्वैत न अद्वैतवादिना परिहर्तव्यो दोषः. Suppose you say that, okay, this bandhavastha, muktavastha, etc., okay, we are dropping that idea, we will not bother about it. Then, for you, then again, shastra, irrelevance of shastra. If you say, we can say, as a non-dualist, we can say, bandhavastha is not there, muktavastha is not there, but then you are a dualist, suppose you say, in order to avoid this anityatva dosha pariharaya, in order to avoid this defect of this atma being anitya, suppose you want to say that there is no bandhavastha, muktavastha, etc., etc., then for you also, because you are holding that bandhavastha is real and muktavastha is real, for you also the shastra will become irrelevant. When you say that atma is nityam and then there is no bandhavastha, there is no muktavastha, for you actually it will become, not for us, for us the shastra is irrelevant, but for you shastra will become irrelevant. So that is what he is saying. Bandha mukta avastha bhedaha na kalpyate. If you don't visualize those things, dvaitinam api shastranarthakyadi doshaha aparihariya eva. Aparihariya means unavoidable, something which is you can't escape, inescapable, let us say. Aparihariya, parihara means something which is, parihara actually in shastra means solving an issue. Aparihariya means something which is unsolvable, something which you can't solve. Aparihariya. This defect is, it will become something which is unsolvable problem, unsolved problem, something like that. It is an unsolved problem for you also. Iti samanatvat. So it is equal to us. So this problem will be equal to us. So why do you put the burden on us only to solve that problem? Samanatvat na advaitavadina parihartavyo doshaha. It is not for us to solve this problem. So then having said that, Shankaracharya is now saying, okay, he has argued something with this contender who is a dualist, but then he has to explain to you and me, because Shankar, the other man might have shut his mouth, but then you and I, we are keen to know, isn't it? You and I, we are keen to know whether how this problem has to be solved. He says this problem is equal to you and me, so I need not solve this problem. So that he sent him away. But then we being his students, we will ask him, sir, how are you going to solve this problem? So we have to, he has to tell us. So for us, he is saying, really there is no shastranarthakyam. In fact, in our case, there is no shastranarthakyam. For him, in his case, there can be shastranarthakyam. But for us, there is no shastranarthakyam. That is what he says. Nacha shastranarthakyam.
Nacha shastranarthakyam.
Yatha prasiddha. अविद्वत् पुरुष विषयत्वात् शास्त्रस्य अविद्वत् पुरुष अविद्वत् पुरुष विषयत्वात् शास्त्रस्य
अविद्वत् पुरुष विषयत्वात् शास्त्रस्य
योर बुक सेज समथिंग डिफरेंट और व्हाट अविद्वत् प्लीज रीड
अविद्वत् पुरुष विषयत्वात्
सेम अविद्वत् पुरुष विषयत्वात् शास्त्रस्य दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट व्हिच शंकराचार्य मेक्स टाइम एंड अगेन in several places, and that is the argument of Vedanta. That is, Shastra is there for this Avidvat Purusha. Avidvan does not mean ignorant, totally ignorant person, etc., etc. Avidvan, we are referring to a person who is not, say, realizing that Atman is Brahman. So, one who is not realizing Atman as Brahman, he is the Avidvan. So whoever has not realized, even all the seekers and all the people who have not realized, they are in that stage. So for them, Shastra is very much relevant. For them, Shastra is very much, Shastra, they can't throw away Shastras. Shastra may become irrelevant for, say, Sarvata Samplutodaka Sthaniya. In Bhagavad Gita, in Gita only we saw, Yava Anartha Udapane Sarvata Samplutodake, second chapter. So for a person who is in that Sarvata Samplutodaka Sthaniya, where he is seeing Brahman everywhere, for him there is no need to say do this, don't do this, that do's and don'ts, they don't, he has gone beyond them. So Traigunya Vishayo Vishaya Veda Nistraigunyo Bhavarjuna, he has gone beyond this Traigunyam, whereas all other people are in this Traigunyam. Traigunyam means samsara. All of us are in this particular lower level only. So long as we are in the lower level, the Shastra is very much relevant. So that is what he says. Then, avasthavan syatrahi dvaitinameva. Let me see, where are we? Shastrasya vidhi pratishedatma deha dhivimanana prasiddhatvat purusha agocharatvat avidvamsa purusha agyana andamatmanam brahmanam. Avidvat purusha vishayatvat shastrasya. Then, is this line clear? Avidvat purusha vishayat. This shastra is always for avidvan. Then, avidusham hi phalahetvoho anatmanoho atmadarshanam.
Na vidusham.
Vidusham hi phalahetubhyam atmano anyatva darshane sati.
Tayoho aham ityatma darshana anupapatte. आत्मदर्शन अनुपपत्ति है
ओके सो अविदुषाम ही मीन्स बिकॉज शास्त्रानर्थ शास्त्र इज ओनली फॉर विद्वत् पुरुष बिकॉज अविदुषाम फलहेत्वोः अनात्मनोः आत्मदर्शनम सो दिस अविद्वान वेर इज यू हैविंग दिस आत्मदर्शनम आत्मदर्शनम मीन्स ही इज आइडेंटिफाइंग विथ समथिंग वाट इज ही आइडेंटिफाइंग विथ फल एंड हेतु फल मीन्स सम रिजल्ट भोक्तृत्व हेतु कर्तृत्व सो ही इज आइडेंटिफाइंग हिमसेल्फ I am karta, I am bhokta, I have to do this, I have to get this result. So, phala hetvoho. So, this is saptami vibhakti. Phala hetvoho. In phala and hetu. Phala hetvoho. Phala in phala and in phala, in hetu. That is, in being a karta, in being a bhokta, in kartrutva and in bhoktrutva. And what are these two? These are anatmanoho. These are actually non-atma. This is nothing to do with Atma. So this Kartrutva, Bhoktrutva, which are Anatmas, in them, this man is having Atma Darshanam. Atma Darshanam means he is identifying himself with that. This Abidusha, Abidusham is Abidvan. Shashti Bahuvachanam is Abidusham. That is in the case of those ignorant people. So that is what it means. For them, so this Atma Darshanam, that is identification of self, is there in Kartrutva and Bhoktrutva. So that is what the sentence means. Is it clear?
Yes.
So an Avidvan, he is always bothered about doing some karma. He always wants to achieve something. He is very much identifying himself as a Karta and a Bhokta. So that is it, Kartrutva and Bhoktrutva. Phala is Bhoktrutva, Hetu is Kartrutva. Then na Vidusham, it is not in the case of a Vidvan, na Vidusham. Then Vidusham he, because in the case of this Vidvans or in the case of this realized persons, then Phalahetubhyam Atmadarshanaha Atmanaha Anyatva Darshane Sati. Then they see, they don't identify with this Phala and Hetu. They see Atman as something different. They see Atman as something different from this Phala and Hetu. They have transcended this particular level. So for them, Tayoho, Tayoho means in them. In this phala and hetu, aham iti atma darshana anupapattehe. So this aham, this notion of I is not there in this phala and hetu. Atma darshana anupapattehe. It is not present there. Anupapatti, it is not there. Say for this wise people or for the realized person, he is not bothered about this kartrutva, bhoktrutva. He is not identifying himself with these things. So that is the position, that is his position. Then nahi atyanta mudaha
unmattadirapi
jalagnyoho
chaya prakashayorva
ekatmatam pashyati kimuta viveki okay. So even a fool, he gives a general say a common example. Nahi atyanta mudaha unmattadirapi. So even a fool or even a very very wild man, unmatta means not wild, that is somebody who is a unmatta is somebody who is in a highly excited manner, somebody who is in some sort of delirium. So in fact that is a better thing, in a state of delirium. So atyanta mudaha unmattadirapi, a person who is in such a deluded state, he will not see water and fire as one. Even a fool will not see, even a fool or a deluded man will not see water and fire as one, and similarly light and darkness as one. Chaya prakashayorva. Chaya is darkness, prakasha is light. For them, ekatmatam na pashyati. So he does not see them as one. So similarly, kimuta viveki. Kimuta means what to talk of. What to talk of a jnani. So here the point is, this avidvan is identifying himself with the phalahetu. Vidvan is not bothered about phalahetu. A vidvan, he will never identify, just as even a fool will not see the unity of darkness and light. A vidvan will never see, he will never identify with this phala and hetu. So that is the question point here. Then tasmat na vidhi na vidhi pratishedha shastram tavat
na vidhi pratishedha shastram tavat
phala hetubhyam atmano anyatva darshinah bhavati
phala hetubhyam atmano anyatva darshinah bhavati.
So for somebody who is seeing atman, for somebody who has realized atman as something different from this total matrix of phala and hetu, somebody who has realized this atman has something different from this phalahetubhyam anyatva darshinah. From the, he has seen atman as something different from the whole matrix, from the whole canvas of this phalam and hetu. So for such a man, na vidhi pratishedha shastram na bhavati. So for a realized person, this vidhi shastram and pratishedha shastram, vidhi means some injunction, you do this, pratishedha means don't, do's and don'ts, they do not apply to him. Is it clear? All this shastram relating to vidhi and pratishedha, they will not apply to somebody who has seen this atma, who has realized atman as something totally beyond this matrix of phala and hetu. So that is the meaning here. Then nahi, devadatta tvamidam kuru.
Devadatta tvamidam kuru.
Iti. Kasminchit karmani niyukte.
Kasminchit karmani niyukte.
Vishnu mitraha. Aham niyukta iti.
Tatrastha.
Niyogam shrunvannapi pratipadyate. Niyoga vishaya viveka.
Agrahanat tu upapadyate pratipattihi.
Tatha phala hetvorapi. Another common example. Nahi devadatta tvamidam kuru. Devadatta, Vishnudatta, these are common names which we find in Devadatta, Vishnumitra, etc. Common names which we find in these Shastra arguments. Devadatta means X, let us say A. Vishnumitra means B, let us say A and B. It is much simpler. Okay, A has been told, you do this. Tvamidam kuru, you do this. Then he has been employed in some karma. Kasminchit karmani niyukte. He has been ordered to do a particular karma. Then Vishnumitraha B. This B, who is standing by? Vishnumitraha tatrasthaha. Tatrasthaha means he is there only. Tatrasthaha, he is there only. And then who is standing by? Aham niyukta iti niyogam shrunvannapi. So though he has heard somebody that X has ordered A to do a particular thing, this B also is present there. B has heard that order, but then B will not go about doing that job. Though he has heard that order being given to A, he will not go because it is not given to him. So similarly for a jnani will not go and do all these karmas which are meant for this ajnani. So here we are talking about jnani and ajnani. So this Vedamata is now saying Agni, that Devadatta, A. Vedamata is saying A. Okay, all these karmas you do. Then Vedamata has, this thing has been heard by the jnani also. This jnani need not do all those karmas. Jnani need not do all those karmas which are applicable to that fellow. Maybe by foolishness or mistake he may do. That is what he is saying. Again, tatrastha niyogam shrunvannapi pratipadyate. So this man, he will not go about doing all those jobs. Then niyoga vishaya viveka agrahanattu upapadyate pratipattihi. Niyoga vishaya viveka agrahanat. Suppose this man, he has not got that viveka. Viveka about who, as to who is being directed, who is not being directed. Niyoga vishaya. Niyoga means employing somebody for some job. Niyoga is employing somebody for some job. So that is why this niyogi word has come. Vaidiki, niyogi, these words have come only because of this. Vaidiki is somebody who did not take up government jobs in olden days. Niyogis are those people who have taken up government jobs in olden days. For example, if you see Erra, Prakada, all these people, they were all mantris. Nannaya, Tikkana, all these people, they were all mantris. So they were all niyogis. They were all niyogis who wrote over great poets. Similarly, Sage Vidyaranya. Sage Vidyaranya was a man from our own Warangal. So he was minister there in that Kakatiya Empire. So then again he took the Sarihara and Bukka to that Hampi, and then he established an empire. On one hand he was looking after these things, and then on the other hand he was also doing this Vedabhashya. So all these people who were employed, they are called niyogis. Niyogi, niyujyate, niyuktaha iti niyogi. Somebody who has been employed is a niyogi. So here, niyoga vishaya viveka agrahanattu upapadyate pratipattih. Suppose somebody who has not properly understood the order, so that man may go. So a real jnani will not get engaged in all those things. Somebody out of confusion, somebody in ignorance may get engaged. But all said and done, that this Vidhi Pratishedha Shastra is only for the ajnani. So that is the whole point here. Tatha phalahetu arapi. Even regarding this phala and hetu, by ignorance or due to ignorance, this man may get into them, but not a jnani. A jnani will never get into them. So that is what he says. Then he said, then there is a small purapaksha. Nanu.
Nanu.
Is the what all we read, is it clear? Okay. Nanu.
Nanu.
Prakruta sambandha apekshaya. युक्तैव प्रतिपत्तिः शास्त्रार्थ विषय फलहेतुभ्याम् अन्य अन्य आत्म विषय दर्शनेपि सति आत्मदर्शन आत्म विषय दर्शनेपि सति इष्टफलहेतौ प्रवर्तितोऽस्मि हेतौ प्रवर्तितोऽस्मि अनिष्टफलहेतोश्च निवर्तितोऽस्मि इति यथा पितृपुत्रादीनां इतरेतर आत्मान्यत्वदर्शने सति दर्शने सत्यपि सत्यपि अन्योन्य नियोग प्रतिषेधार्थ प्रतिपत्तिः निषेध प्रतिषेध वन एंड सेम. ओके, वर्ड्स आर क्वाइट बिग बट द मीनिंग इज क्वाइट सिंपल. ननु, सो ही इज गिविंग ए स्मॉल से द काउंटर पॉइंट. दिस पूर्वपक्षी इज गिविंग ए स्मॉल काउंटर पॉइंट. Okay, you say that a jnani is not going to get engaged in action. All these karmas are only for ajnani. Then, maybe by sheer force of habit, prakruta sambandha apekshaya, prakruta. Prakruta means, samskruta, prakruta. These two are words are totally opposed words, you know. This prakruta means driven by ignorance. By ignorance, suppose somebody is jumping into some fire. You also jump into fire to pick him up or to rescue him. Of course, that is valor, that is a commendable thing. But I am just giving an example. It may not be the perfect example. Suppose you jump into the fire from where there is no way to rescue him. So, something like that. So, just an example. Prakruta sambandha apekshaya. Because of the fact of this affinity built up due to ignorance, some closeness built up due to ignorance, yuktaiva pratipattihi shastrartha vishaya. So it may be possible for somebody to get into some action which is meant for somebody else. And he is giving the example of father and son. Yatha pitru putradinam. So a father and son, suppose the father and son are there. Father falls sick. And then he is not able to perform his daily karmas. And then the son, he is supposed to do his karma, all his daily activities. Suppose the father and son are there. There all this daily activity like the Nitya Devata Archana and all these things the son has to do. Suppose the son is not able to do for some reason, some problem, some health reason, some problem. The father is supposed to do that. So because the son is supposed to, he performs all the jobs which are either not done by the father or due to inability or some reason. That is why he is called Putra. He is the man who is supposed to save him from particular some narakam, isn't it? So, Putrena ayam loko jayaha, we saw in Kathopanishad also. Putra is Putreshana, Viteshana, Lokeshana, Lokeshana and say that Viteshana. Putreshana is for what? That is ayam loko jayaha. So, you are going to conquer this world means what? You are going to follow dharma, all the principles of dharma, all the norms of dharma you are able to follow because of your son. in case you fail to do something, your son is going to take it up and then your son is going to fulfill. So that is the reason. So like that, so somebody, though X is, A has been ordered to do a thing, B also may take up because of this Prakruta Sambandha, because of, maybe by force of habit also, that is what he says. Prakruta Sambandha Apekshaya Yukta Eva Pratipattihi. Pratipatti means Jnanam or Abhipraya, or the notion that I have been directed. So Phalahetubhyam Anyatma Vishaya Darshane Api Sati. Though a person, he is having some sort of theoretical knowledge that Atma is different from this Phala and Hetu. That is the meaning of this line. Phalahetubhyam Anya Atma Vishaya Darshane Api Sati. That is, though a person is having some knowledge that this Atma is something different from this matrix of Phala and Hetu. So, though that knowledge is there, then even then somebody may say, Ishta Phala Hetau Pravartitosmi. Okay, I like this very much. Okay, I like this particular puja very much. I want to perform this puja and I want to go to Venkatayam, do this particular yajna. I want this punyam also. Of course, we are not talking about jnani karma. We are talking about somebody who is really getting interested in karma. Phala hetu. We have to see that phalam hetu. Kartrutva and bhoktrutva also is there. So, when bhoktrutva is not there, then he becomes a jnani. Kartrutva, bhoktrutva, when they both are not there. Then, when kartrutva alone is there, he becomes a karma yogi. When kartrutva and bhoktrutva both are not there, he becomes a jnani. So, here we are not talking about that level. We are talking about somebody who may be having some theoretical knowledge that Atma is something different. But still, I like this puja, I want some punyam, I want to go to some heaven, etc., etc. So, ishtaphala hetau pravartitosmi. Then, anishtaphala hetoscha nivartitosmi. I don't want this, so I am doing this something. I don't want this, I am doing this particular yajna to avoid something. So, all these things. Then, the example is yatha. Pitruputradinam itaretara atmanyatva darshane satyape. Itaretara atmanyatva. Atmanyatva means his self is different from myself. Atma anyatva darshana. Itaretara atma anyatva darshana. That is, these two are totally different people. Father and son, after all, two different people. Atmanyatva darshana. His self is different, my self is different. Even then, Atmanyatva darshane satyapi. Satyapi means even though. Sati plus api. Though it is so, then anyonya niyoga pratishedhartha pratipatihi. So anyonya niyoga. Whatever is told to one man, the other man is doing. Whatever one is not capable of doing, the other man is trying to complement. So that is the point here. Pratishedhartha pratipattihi. So that understanding, with that understanding that okay, father is not able to do, I will do. So for various reasons, one may get into that. So that is what this Purvapakshi says. Then Siddhanti says, Na. Vyatiriktatma darshana pratipatte prageva.
Vyatiriktatma darshana pratipatte prageva.
Phalahetvoho atmabhimanasya siddhatvat. प्रतिपन्न नियोग प्रतिषेधार्थो हि फलहेतुभ्याम आत्मनो अन्यत्वं प्रतिपद्यते न पूर्वम् तस्मात् विधि प्रतिषेध शास्त्रम् अविद्वद् विषयमिति सिद्धम्. ओके. So, he says, it is not possible. Vyatirekatma darshana pratipatte prageva phalahetuho atmabhimanase siddhatvat. The language is rather tough, meaning is simple. Vyatirekatma darshana pratipatte prak. That means, before one realizes that Atma is something different from this body. Vyatireka Atma Darshana. This Vyatireka Atma Darshana means Vyatirikta. Vyatma Vyatirikta means something which is, Atma is something which is different. Atma is something different from this body-mind complex. And this Atma is something which is not different from Brahman. So that knowledge, that awareness. Pratipatteha Prak. Pratipatti means Jnanam. Pratipatteha Prak means before one attains such knowledge. Before one attains such knowledge, it is only then, Prag Eva. It is only then It is only when this man is still, when he has not attained that particular knowledge, then only phalahetuoho atmabhimanase siddhatvat. Only then he will have this atmabhimanam, or he will have this identification with this phala and hetu. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
The point is, only when he is in ajnana, when he has not realized, before realization, realization prageva, that is pratipatteha prageva, that is before he has realized this atma, then he might get into some confusion. But then pratipanna niyoga pratishedharthohi, that is one who has initially followed some karma path. You see, pratipanna niyoga pratishedharthaha, that is one who has followed that path for some time. Initially he has followed that path for some time, and then say for such person, later he realizes this atmanaha anyatvam. Later he realizes that atma is something different from the self, and then he gives it up. So na purvam, only when he realizes that atma is something different from this body mind complex, and atma is something which is not different from Brahman, then only he gives up all these things. Na purvam, before that he cannot give up. So tasmat, therefore, vidhi pratishetha shastram, this shastram which is talking about do's and don'ts, avidvad vishayam, this belongs to, or this pertains to this avidvan, this pertains to this avidvan only, iti siddham, it is very very clear. So that is what he says. Then again another small purapaksha, nanu svargakamo yajeta, na kalanjam bhakshayed, अतः कर्तुरभावात् शास्त्रानर्थक्यमिति चेत् न. Okay, so this Purvapaksha, he is again saying. So he is saying, he is visualizing a situation. So this situation is, he is talking about two types of people. He is talking about one a jnani, and then one is a Dehatmavadi. Dehatmavadi is, in the present day, in the modern language, if we want to say a rationalist, let us say, in the present day, say, parlance, he may be a rationalist. Or he may be rationalist also, we should not say, let us say atheist, because Vedanta also is highly rational. Vedanta is not irrational. Vedanta, what all we discuss is something which is based on reason only. So somebody who is an atheist, let us say. So this atheist, so he is talking about two types of people. One is a jnani who has risen beyond this karma, phala, hetu, etc. And then there is a Dehatmavadi. Dehatmavadi means a fellow like that Virochana, coming example of Virochana, where he is identifying himself with this body-mind complex, and he wants to have all bodily pleasures. So this body, apart from body, there is nothing else. So that Charvakavadi. So is a total materialist, let us say. Materialist is a better word. Okay, this Purvapakshi is talking about two types of people. One is a Jnani and one is a materialist. Jnani is leaving all these shastras, thinking that they are irrelevant. This materialist, he is not bothered about it. He is already calling it trash. Like our minister who some time ago said, all these Vedas, you go and throw them in Bangala, Bay of Bengal, one minister said. So some time ago, not now, some time ago. So it is like that. That minister is again an atheist. So like that, there can be people. So when that is so, then the Shastranarthakyam will arise. All the Shastras will become irrelevant. So that is the picture. Nanu Svargakamo Yajeta. There is one line from somewhere, some portion of Veda. So one who desires Svarga, he has to perform a Yajna. This is one order. Then there is another order. Na Kalanjam Bhakshayet. Kalanjam. Kalanjam, of course, there are two different meanings given. One is, suppose in olden days when people, even now, when people hunt, they put some poison to that head of that arrow and then they shoot. And then an animal which is shot and then which is killed by using a poisoned arrow. that should not be eaten. The meat of that animal is called kalanjam. Kalanjam is that meat which is meat of an animal which is killed by a poisoned arrow. So naturally, because poison is there, it should not be eaten, something like that. Because ultimately, naturally, you are also taking some poison slowly. So that is the meaning maybe. So, na kalanjam bhakshayet. Another meaning given was kalanjam is some garlic. So maybe later day people might have interpreted it as garlic. So, na kalanjam bhakshayet. So whatever meaning is not very important here. So these are vidhi and nishetha. One is Svargakama Yajeta, you do this. Na Kalanjam Bhakshayet, you don't do this. This is Nishedha. So, this Vidhi and Pratishedha are there. So, these things, Ityadav, in these cases, Ityadav, Atmavyatireka Darshinam Apravruttav. So, this Atmavyatireka Darshi. Atmavyatireka Darshi means one who is seeing this body, one who is seeing Atman as different from this body-mind complex. So, he is Atma Vitreka Darshi. One who is seeing this Atma as something different from this BMI and then something which is same as Brahman. So, for such a man, apravruttihi. Apravrutti means he is not getting engaged in that. Pravrutti means getting engaged in an action. Apravrutti means not getting engaged in that action. So, in the case of this man who knows that Atma is something which is akarta, abhokta, etc., etc., for him, there is no pravritti in this action. And for this kevala dehadhyatma drushtinam cha means and also for this kevala dehadhyatma drushtinam. So, kevala dehatmavadi, that is one who is reveling in his sensual pleasures and happily there, and then he is not bothered about vidhi nisheda. He goes and kills and eats anything, he does anything he wants. So that is it, that is the style. Ataha, kartuhu abhavat. So then there is no karta. So shastram is there only when there is karta, isn't it? Kartuhu abhavat, shastranarthakyam iti chetna. Shastranarthakyam is, shastra will become irrelevant. So here, of course, kartur abhavat, the question is, there is what is called kartradhikaranam in Brahma Sutras. Kartradhikaranam, of course, it's not very, very relevant. I am just mentioning here. There, the question is, all these shastras are there. So, for whom are they meant? So, the question is, are they meant for the intellect or are they meant for the jiva? So, there is a fine distinction between intellect and jiva. So, it is meant for the intellect, that is the Purvapaksha. No, it is not meant for that thing. It is meant for the jiva only. Because jiva is the karta. This jiva is the karta, and then for this jiva only all these things are mentioned. After all, the world has to continue, the whole transaction, all worldly transactions have to continue. World should have a harmonious social life. So all these rituals and all these karmas have been told to ensure this all social transactions have to be harmonious. So from that point of view, and then karma yoga and all these things, they will also hold good. They will also hold good only when jiva is having this, say, this duty of a karma. When jiva is not having the duty of karma, then karma yoga, etc. will not be there. So, there is an adhikarana called kartradhikarana in Vedanta, in this Brahma Sutras, where this question is discussed in a more elaborate manner. But here Shankaracharya is very, very briefly touching that point. Kartuhu abhavat. Kartuhu, when there is no karta, in that kartradhikaranam, the sutram is karta shastrarthavatvat, karta shastrarthavatvat, that is the say Brahma Sutra there, that is shastrasya arthavatvat, this shastra is purposeful, this shastra is meaningful, so that is why this jiva is the karta, so that is the meaning of that thing, jiva is the karta, that is established in that particular adhikarana. So anyway, here the Purvapakshi says, because this karta will not be there, shastra anarthakyam will result. So that is it. Iti chet na. Siddhanti says, no, it is not like that. Yatha prasiddhita eva. Pravrutti nivrutti upapatte hai. Ishvar kshetra jnaikatva darshakatvi. एकत्वदर्शी ब्रह्मवित तावत् न प्रवर्तते तथा नैरात्म्यवाद्यपि नास्ति परलोक इति न प्रवर्तते। ओके, इट इज स्टिल गोइंग ऑन, बट डू वी हैव टाइम? It is almost over. If it is almost over, I think we will continue this Purvapaksha in this Siddhanta in the next class. So what he is going to say is, this Kshetrajnyaikatvadarshi, okay, Brahmavit may not get engaged in action. Then Dehatmavadi also may not get engaged in action. But then there are any number of people. So he is now coming to statistics. So Shankaracharya, this in his reply, he is coming to statistics. He is going to say that there is hardly 1 in 100,000 people who is a jnani. Of course, Dehatmavadis may be there. But a majority of people, lot many people, they are going and listening to pravachanams. Purana pravachanam, if it is there, thousands and thousands of people will be listening. But in a Vedanta class, hardly 5-6 people will be there. So that is what he is going to say. So we'll see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेव अवशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति।